Hello, in this lecture we will see linear and time invariant system. So this is one of the most important class of systems which is known as LTI systems. And the LTI system is one who satisfies both linearity and time invariance properties. Okay, so this type of systems are known as LTI systems. And for LTI systems, the impulse response characterizes the system completely. So the impulse response, if you know the impulse response of such a system, then you know everything about that system. So what does it mean? What is the impulse response? So let us see what is an impulse response. So suppose this is a system, and if we excite this system by an impulse, and whatever we get at the output, provided this system is relaxed and we apply an impulse here, and whatever we get at the output is known as the impulse response. So this is the response due to an impulse. That's why this is known as impulse response and denoted by h of t. So this is known as impulse response. This is impulse response. Now if you know the h of t, then you can calculate the output due to any arbitrary input, say x of t. Now provided h of t, if you apply x of t here, then we can get output for this arbitrary input by a convolution of this input with the impulse response h of t. Okay, now this symbol is used for convolution and it is given by y of t equal to x of t convolved with h of t, which is equal to integration tau from minus to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So this is the formula of convolution. Now let us formally derive the response due to an arbitrary input, that is convolution. So for this system, so this is a LTI system, okay, and now we know that if we apply an impulse delta t here, we will get h of t. Okay, now due to time invariance property, since this system is LTI and so it satisfies both linearity and time invariance properties. So due to time invariance property, if I delay this input by tau, that means delta t minus tau, then the output will also get delayed by tau. So this is due to time invariance property. Now due to homogeneity property, if I scale this input by some constant, say x of tau, then the output will also be scaled by x of tau and we will get h of t minus tau as an output, and this is due to homogeneity property. Okay, now due to the additivity property, if I integrate all such inputs, then means if I take all such inputs, then the output will also be added. So this will get as an output x of tau h of t minus tau d tau, and this is due to additivity. So what we get here is the output y of t, and if you notice that this is nothing but x of t. This is representation of x of t in terms of shifted and scaled unit impulses. Okay, so this is output y t due to this input x of t, and this is nothing but formula of convolution. So it means y of t is x of t convolution h of t. This is the formula of convolution. So this is, in this way we have derived the output y t due to an arbitrary input x of t, which is the convolution. Okay, so we can say that this is some LTI system, and for any input x of t we get y of t. Let us say this system has an impulse response h of t, then y t is nothing but x of t convolution with h of t. Now let us see few properties of convolution integral. The first property is that this convolution integral is commutative. So this is commutative, means x of t convolved with h of t is equal to h of t convolved with x of t. Let us prove this. Okay, so since h of t convolved with h of t is equal to limit tau from minus infinity to plus infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So in this case we keep x of tau fix and we flip and shift h of tau. Okay, now let us let t minus tau equal to lambda, then this limit we can change lambda from minus to plus infinity. Now from here I can write tau equal to t minus lambda, so this will be x of t minus lambda h of lambda d lambda, which is h of lambda x of t minus lambda d lambda. Okay, and if you see this, this is nothing but h of t convolution with x of t. Okay, so this is the proof of commutative property. Now the second property says that the convolution integral is associative, means x of t convolved with h1 of t, and this result is convolved with h2 of t. This will be equal to x of t convolved with the convolution of h1t and h2t. The third property is distributive property, which says that x of t convolved with h1t plus h2t is equal to convolution of xt with h1t plus convolution of xt with h2t. Okay, so what we have seen in this lecture is what is an LTI system and what is impulse response of an LTI system, and how to calculate the response of an LTI system to an arbitrary input. And we have seen that this is given by the convolution integral. So this is convolution integral. Okay, and we have derived the response due to an arbitrary input for an LTI system, and further we have seen the properties of this convolution which is commutative, associative and distributive. So we stop here and continue next lecture. Thank you.